ए लेफ्ट साइड सीक्वेंस इज वन फॉर विच एक्स ऑफ एन इज इक्वल टू जीरो फॉर ऑल वैल्यूज ऑफ एन इज ग्रेटर देन जीरो. नथिंग बट एज आई टोल्ड द सीक्वेंस इज प्रेजेंट बिफोर जीरो दैट इज कॉल्ड एज लेफ्ट साइड सीक्वेंस आर वी कैन से दैट नॉन कॉजल सीक्वेंस फॉर आफ्टर जीरो nothing but n is greater than equal n is greater than 0 the sample should be what 0 meaning is simple the sequence should be present before 0 that is called as left side sequence after 0 it is 0 so that type of sequence is called as left side sequence or we can say that non causal sequence or we can say that negative time sequence these are all what negative values these are all what positive values. Okay. Now, the resulting sequence x of n is called as anti-causal or non-causal sequence. For such type of sequence, ROC is what? Here I am going to write ROC. ROC is what? ROC is entire Z plane. ROC is entire Z plane. But except at z equal to infinity. So this one we'll discuss by taking one example. I will take one example. Find the z transform and ROC for the sequence. Find the Z transform and ROC for the sequence x of n is equal to 1, 1, 2, 2. Upward arrow mark here. So already told, upward arrow mark indicates that is 0th sample. It is n equal to 0 and this one is n equal to minus 1, this one is n equal to minus 2, this one is n equal to minus 3. So we can say that first I will write the definition of ZT here. X of Z is equal to summation n equal to minus infinity to plus infinity x of n Z to the power minus n. So it is a definition of Z transform. Let's see here, limits varies from minus infinity to plus infinity, but for the given sequence, this sequence has the four samples. It has four samples. It varies from n equal to, this is what? N equal to minus 3. So n equal to minus 3, nothing but n equal to 0, n equal to minus 1, n equal to minus 2, n equal to minus 3. It varies from n equal to minus 3 to n equal to 0. So because of that reason, I'm going to rewrite limits as x of z equal to summation n equal to minus 3 to 0 x of n z to the power minus n. Very simple. Next step is substitution of n values from minus 3 to 0. X of z equal to n equal to minus 3. What we are getting? X of minus 3 z to the power minus n equal to what we take? Minus 3. Minus 3 plus next value n equal to minus 2. X of minus 2 z into z to the power minus of minus 2. Okay. Next. I will take n equal to minus 1, x of minus 1, okay, z to the power minus of minus 1, next n equal to 0, x of 0, z to the power 0. So for the simplification, x of z equal to, x of minus 3 is how much? X of minus 3 is 1, 1, minus into minus plus, z to the power 3, plus x of minus 2 is how much? X of minus 2 is 1. 1 minus into minus plus into z to the power 2 plus x of minus 1 is how much? 2 minus into minus plus z to the power 1 x of 0 is how much? 2 z to the power 0. So for the simplification, x of z equal to z cube z square z plus, sorry, here 2 is there, plus 2. Okay. This is our Z transform for the given sequence. The thing is that we discuss here for left sided sequence, or we can say that for non causal sequence, or we can say that negative time sequence, ROC is entire z plane but except z equal to infinity. Because in this result, if you substitute z equal to infinity, what we are getting? We are getting infinite result. Because of that reason, what we are telling? The ROC lies in the entire z plane but at z equal to infinity. Always convergence means, existence means, there should be a finite result. Because of that reason, if you substitute any value here for z equal to, substitute any value, you are getting ROC. Existence is there. Z transform existence is there. Only when, if you substitute z equal to infinity, we are getting infinite result. Because of that reason, we are saying that for left-sided sequence or for non-causal sequence, ROC is entire z plane except z equal to infinity. It is about left-sided sequence, or we can say that non-causal sequence.